Hi friends, welcome to JOSAT. Today we are going to see Pedagogy of Computer Science Unit 1. Unit 1 is all about aims and objective of teaching computer science. Let's move on to the objective of this unit. We will be going to study about aims and objective of teaching computer science, analyze the need and significance of teaching computer science and the values of teaching computer science. Let's move on to the introduction part. Computer technology is used in almost every sector of everyday life, including business, laboratories, educational institutions, research, etc. In the current world, it is almost impossible to imagine that someone can live without computer. Today, everything related to your everyday life can be done using computer. Let's move on to the meaning, nature and scope of teaching computer science. Meaning, computer science is an electronic device which works under a given set of instructions. Computer science is the scientific and a practical approach of a computation and its applications. It can be divided into a variety of theoretical and practical disciplines where computer science is considered to be closer relationship with mathematics more than any other scientific disciplines. Computer science is the studying the properties of computations. Let's move on to the nature of computer science. Nature of computer science is access to expert and respected peers, one-to-one and many communication, active learner participants, linking of new learning to concrete on the job problems, follow-up feedback and implementation support from the peers. Computer science graduates earn higher salary and the computer science major gets more job opportunities. Computer science graduates join more and fast-growing industries. Computer science degree holders work in a wide range of industries. Computer science graduates can help make the world more better place. Let's see the scope of computer science in the field. Software development, hardware engineer, system design, system analyst, networking engineer and DBA. Let's move on to one by one. Software developer. Software developer are who are concerned with the phases of software development process. Hardware engineers. They do research, design, implement, develop, test and oversee the installation of hardware are called hardware engineers. System design. System design involved in system designing, that is local design and physical design, wherein local design can be structured and characterized such as input, output, file, database, etc. Whereas a physical design is a structure of window and screen of applications. Next is system analyst. They do research about existing problem and plan to solve the problems in the systems. Networking engineers. They are the computer professional involved in designing, implementation and troubleshooting of the computer networks. Next is DBA. DBA means database administrator. Database administrator is the professional job to design, implement and manage and maintain the repair of the organization's database. Scope of other fields using computer science, let's see them. There are 14 scope and of the other fields using computer science. First is routine job handling, which is used in salary, tax, etc. Second is electronic money, which is a ATM. And third is electronic office, which is fax, email usage. And fourth is education, like computer science and 12th and colleges. Fifth is defense, weapons, control system, etc. And sixth is space science, that is satellite controlling system. And seventh is medicine, the usage of ECG scan. Eighth is scientific research, that is the time and energy used in the research. Ninth is traffic control, lights and signals used for the traffic control. And tenth is industrial applications. Industrial applications like trade and industry. And 11th is telephones, that is STD and ISD and mobile phones. And 12th is trade, that is bank and stock exchange. 13th is film industry, that is animation and filtering, etc. And 14th is communication, which is phone, printer, fax and email used as a computer system, etc. These are the scope of other field using computer science. Let's move on to the aim and objective of teaching computer science in school. Let's see the aim. The term aim means the broad goals which our educational system embraces and which we are expected to attain. Education is to develop patriotism and good citizenship. Education for a moral, ethic and spiritual values, and it is education for a leisure time activity such as music, dance, gardening, reading, hobby, etc. Special education for disabled students. Objectives. Objectives are the milestone to reach the destination, that is to attain the aim or ultimate goal of education. A point or an end view of something towards which action is directed. A planned change so through an activity which what we set out to do. The changes that takes place through education can be represented the knowledge children that acquire, the skills and abilities children attain, the interest the children develop, the attitude that children manifest. Education is the process of bringing about changes in the behavior of the students in what they know is knowledge, how they think is thinking, how they feel is feeling, how they work is working. So knowledge, thinking, feeling and working. These are the four things. And let's move on to the aim of teaching computer science in school. Concept, information and skill which could be immediately used and applied. Training for developing skills in handling effectively and also in a problem solving skills. Develop a developed computer science related attitudes. Appreciation of the contributes of computer science scientists. Training in making best use of the leisure time. Objectives of teaching computer science in school. They are successful professionals, have a broad knowledge and thinking independently, acquires knowledge and continue their development, apply scientific and engineering methodology to design, implementation and analyze and evaluate, communicate effectively both orally and in a writing. Let's see the difference between aim and objective. Aims are long-term goals, whereas objective are a short-term goal. Aim are a broad and common, whereas objectives are narrow and specific. Aim, philosophy, sociology and main source, whereas objective is psychologically is the main source. Aim, there are difficult to achieve, where objective they can be achieved conveniently. Aim can't be evaluated, where objective can be evaluated. Aim in school, society and nation is responsible. In objective, generally teacher is only responsible. Aim is non-observable and whereas objective is observable behavior. Aim is to achieve, we have to go beyond a curriculum. But objective is achievable within the curriculum. Next is aim and objective of teaching computer science in high school level. Arousing and maintaining interest, developing the habits of observation and the way of thinking, understanding the impact of computer science in our way of life, developing the interest in hobbies related to computers. Next is aim and objective of teaching computer science in higher secondary school. To develop scientific attitude, a desire for accurate knowledge, belief in cause and effect and critical thinking and intellectual honesty, open-mindedness and so on. Next, let's see the needs and significance of teaching computer science. Introduction. Computer science knowledge is very important for other subjects. The aims and objective of computer science teaching having undergone an inverse change in the computer era. In the growth and development of an individual and to apply a computer knowledge and skills in the working place, we need computer science knowledge. Needs of teaching computer science. Every time, everyone, everywhere, we find the use of computer in some form or other. Computer science is the hallmark of human civilization, where the rate of knowledge exploration has increased exponentially. The whole world has become global village because of computer and their latest applications. To know the worlds around us, computer is needed. To develop the skill in the use of network, internet, social media, and to understand the natural phenomena clearly, computer science technology is needed. To develop self-confidence, self-reliance, and patience, and to apply mathematical concept and the principles in the new situation, and to apply the computer science knowledge and the skills in the working place and in the other school subject, computer science teaching is necessary. Significance of teaching computer science are of five significance: modernizing education, improving students' performance, learning job skill, efficiency, and research. Let's see one by one. Modernizing education. Education has benefited from the inclusion of technology and computers by making it easier for students to keep up, while teachers by improving the way the lesson can be planned and taught. Students can also look up lessons on websites or email instead of taking heavy textbooks. Next is improving students' performance. Students who use computers have been seen to attend school more steadily and perform better than the other students. Using computer, students become more focused on their work at home. Third is learning job skill. Computer plays a vital role in the modern business world, and many basic jobs involve technology and computers. Teaching computer to students helps them prepare for any number of possible work. Many teach students to create program presentation and database. Fourth is efficiency. It makes the learning process a lot more simple and efficient. For example, students can check their grade and lesson plan online. Students can also communicate with their teachers through email and also send their work to teachers from home. Fifth is research. Technology has made research far easier than before. As the internet has grown, many research options are available and students can do research topic in a few minutes instead of taking long time. Today, many of books are available in digital format and can be accessed online. Next, we are going to see the value of teaching computer science. Importance and functions of value. Values are general principle to regulate our day-to-day behavior, where our values are the basis of our judgment about what is desirable, proper, correct, important, worthwhile, and goods. Let noble thoughts come to me from all directions. Live with this objective. Let's see the value of teaching computer science. Practical value, social value, disciplinary value, cultural value, moral value. Let's see one by one. Practical value, utilization of the various facts drawn from the study of computer science in modern life. Today we cannot find even a single thing which is left untouched by the hands of computer. Uses of computers in transportation and communication have shortened the world. In short, computers have been a part of our life, and without them, it is impossible to keep ourselves alive in the modern world. Second is social value. Computers have achieved the best place in the society as well. They form the foundation of so many professionals like medicine, engineer, etc. Computers are highly helpful to the society. A lot of social changes have taken place after the introduction of computers. Third is disciplinary value. The learning of computer science involves some scientific discipline and scientific attitude, which are transferable to our later life also. It involves self-expression, creativeness, open-minded critical thinking and observation, suspend judgment, which are free from superstitious and false belief, etc. Fourth is cultural value. The role of computer in the development of modern civilization can be quite obvious. Standard of living gives a clear-cut picture of cultural development. Cultural development role of computer remove old traditional belief and superstitions. Fifth is moral value. Moral values are the standard of good and evil which governs an individual behavior. Science has more moral value. Science is the search of truth in a faithful manner. It teaches the pupil to be intellectually honest and truthful in our daily life activities. Unit 1 in Pedagogy of Computer Science is over. Let's see the questions of the Unit 1. Explain the nature and scope of teaching computer science. Explain the objective of teaching computer science. And third, list the value of teaching computer science. Fourth is needs and significance of teaching computer science. Notes for this unit is given below in the description box. And please subscribe my channel for more updates. And all the best for your exam. Thank you, friends.